In a new story in the New York Times this weekend, there's more evidence that Michael Flynn was acting on behalf of President Trump's transition team when he was in contact with the Russian ambassador to the United States. Joining me now from Washington, D.C. is one of the reporters on that story, Sharon Lafreniere. So what did the White House say at the time of his firing, and what did you find?
So the narrative until Friday was that Michael Flynn had talked to the Russian ambassador about the sanctions on December 29th, and there was nothing illegal or unethical about that, but he did not own up to it when Vice President Pence and others in the White House asked him about it. But what we learned on Friday was that before he talked to the Russian ambassador and after he talked to the Russian ambassador, Michael Flynn was in touch with senior members of the transition team. So that raises the question of why were they saying that they were left in the dark if others on the transition team knew what he was doing?
There was a tweet that one of your colleagues, Michael Schmidt, put out. This is a photograph, it looks like, of an email by KT McFarlane. And she says in there, among a couple of things, she says, my take. And then one of the things she says in there, that's kind of a phrase that stood out to a lot of people, that this would box Trump in diplomatically with Russia. If there's a tit-for-tat escalation, Trump will have difficulty improving relations with Russia, which has just thrown USA election to him. The word thrown USA election, I mean, is this a phrase that somebody would say casually? Is there something more to this?
What the White House says is that they were not, she was not saying that Russia threw the election to Trump. She was saying that the Democrats are spinning it as Russia threw the election to Trump. And that's not what she meant. So it could be a misreading, but it is clear from the emails that she was very concerned about the sanctions. And the Trump team was upset about these sanctions. They saw them as like a last-minute grenade that the Obama administration was throwing in their lap on the way out the door. And it was a way for the Obama administration to discredit Trump's victory because the sanctions were in response to Russia's meddling in the elections. And they're trying to box him in diplomatically so he can't improve relations with Russia. Mm-hmm. And, you know, overall, this is a big problem for us. And she ends that email with, General Flynn will be talking to the Russian ambassador tonight. And so that her email then is forwarded to six other transition officials, including Sean Spicer, Ryan Priebus, Steve Bannon. Yeah. And then 2 days later, Michael Flynn has another conversation with Kislyak, and he himself briefs senior members of the transition team about that conversation, and it again is about sanctions. So it sort of begs the question if Sean Spicer, Priebus and Bannon all knew that he was talking to the Russian ambassador about sanctions, who was being left in the dark?
So what do these emails show? Is it a matter of impropriety going against the wishes of the Obama administration, or is there something illegal about having these sorts of conversations?
No, there isn't. It appears there's nothing illegal about having these sorts of conversations. And the Obama administration didn't want them to have these conversations, right? They had asked them, you know, please don't subvert, you know, U.S. policy. There can only be one president at a time. If you're going to have conversations with foreign officials and stakeholders, that's fine, but bring along a State Department person so there's a record of that. And none of that happened.
All right. Sharon Lafreniere, one of the team of reporters at the New York Times that worked on this story this weekend. Thanks so much.
Thanks for having me.